decide to release a retrospective album now?
It's a kind of timely thing. I'm just running out of contract. I've been in a record contract for my sins for the last 30 years. Different sorts of contracts that just extended on and on. And now that has come to a conclusion, and it just is the right thing to do, to release a retrospective. It's like a demarcation line in a way, because there is that body of work to look back on in retrospect, and the future is ahead of me, and that's very interesting because I'm really not sure exactly what that's going to mean logistically, you know, how that's going to pan out, but I'm very excited about it because of internet technology.
Oh, really? Internet technology specifically? Why is that?
Because I think for artists like myself, I like to communicate with people, and not only through music and singing, but to actually, I write blogs, I use MySpace in that sense, and it's a very helpful tool, an activist tool in actual fact. That's one aspect of what I do. And creatively, I love to do things like make little videos or photographs or just discuss with people differently. So I think in the future that many artists will use the internet to have their own independent broadcasting station, just that is them. So my website will be a place where people can come and they can see the broad spectrum, the broad body of my work. From the past, from every aspect of it. So it's like a holding bay for that whole thing. And that's really thrilling for me.
You've always been a thorn in the side, but to me, you're a shining light. You arrive and the night is alive. Yeah, you are a shining light. Yeah.
What was it about the song Shining Light that grabbed you?
Well, I first heard it in 2001, so it's quite a few years ago, and it's one of those incredible anthemic songs that just stay with you. You know, it's like when you heard Jeff Buckley's version of Leonard Cohen's Hallelujah. You heard it's almost like a revelation when you hear it. You can't forget that song, and it's a song that will last forever, and I think that Shining Light is just the most extraordinary song, and because I have that relationship to it, I wanted to explore it and see what it would be like if I could do a version of it.
Over the years, your music videos have served as an outlet to explore different personas. Is that a cathartic process for you?
Performance feels quite cathartic, to be honest with you. It's a good feeling. And songwriting is cathartic because you have something that you want to express. You might not even know what it is at the beginning because you're inventing it. And ultimately, when you've completed that songwriting process, there is a sense of yes, completion, that it's out, it's expressed, it's done, and then you can communicate it to other people in performance. Yes, but I mean, obviously when I'm performing, I have to be quite disciplined. I'm not actually feeling the sentiments as I'm singing them, but I'm using them as a vehicle to just communicate with people, to allow them to kind of tune in with that.
You come across as extremely fearless in your videos, yet you've said that as a person you're quite shy. Mm-hmm. But you're not really, you don't seem that shy to me.
No, I'm not shy right now,
right.
But I can be quite shy. It depends on the circumstances, you know. And I think that probably a lot of my shyness came from the fact that I was an only child and I spent a lot of time by myself and I didn't have that raucous interaction with other siblings where I had to fight for my space and all of that. Shyness is actually quite crippling when one is shy. It's not helpful, you know. But a lot of being on stage has given me that opportunity to kind of go beyond my normal persona.
Video for Little Bird. You were 7 months pregnant?
I was, yes.
What do you remember about making that video? Apart from being 7 months pregnant?
Yes. Well, I obviously the timing was a little strange because I wanted to make the video and I knew that, you know, being pregnant, I would really have to kind of be quite careful about my energy level. So I thought, I know, I'll have other people take my place. And so that was really that's kind of how that first little spark of an idea came about, to bring in different people to sort of help me because I was pregnant. And And then I thought, wow, that, you know, each individual could then become the personas that I had kind of performed through in the videos. And that was just, it was mad. It was wonderful. It was exciting. It was a crazy day. Won't you pick the pieces up? 'Cause it feels just like I'm a walking on broken glass. Walking on broken glass.
Which music video are you most proud of?
Quite a few. I'm really, you know, I think that Broken Glass is just, it's hilarious, you know. I mean, a lot of the things I do have got humour in them. But the fact that we had John Malkovich who came in and you know, and Hugh Laurie was there and some, you know, we had a big cast. I'm living in an empty room with all the windows smashed. Actually, now that I'm saying that, also, and No More I Love You's actually probably is the most, I consider the most beautiful video that among others that we've managed. When I say I mean we, because I've worked with people and the technicians and other directors and people that have to design costumes. Well, I have the ideas what I want, but they kind of help me to manifest those things. Everything that you do actually behind the scenes, the things that people don't see, it's teamwork. So, you know, the ultimate thing is what you present to people, but there's so much work involved that people have no idea about. No more I love you.
Language is leaving me. Obviously, your extreme sense of style over the years has been a big part of who you are as an artist. Do you ever look back at some of those signature looks and think, wow, they're either shocking or you're surprised?
Well, they were what I was doing at the time, you know, that was what I was doing at the time. And sometimes it was a little bit extreme. It kind of pushed the boundary, and I found that interesting. To as a performer, it is a visual thing. You kind of manifest your music through yourself, you know, and I thought that's so wonderful. So, yeah, I look back and I go, well, I was doing that then and all that stuff. But when I look back on my solo career, I really like the imagery. I feel very grateful to have worked with some fantastic photographers and, you know, the people that brought the elements together with me. Because I think to make lasting imagery, photographic imagery, is I mean, I love the photographic image, just generally speaking. And so I really, you know, I kind of value some of the things that I've done, and I think, yeah, that's I like that. That was okay. Tell me why.
A lot of your songs are about pain and failed relationships. Do you still feel that you have a lot to learn about love?
I think we all do. I think the world needs to be a far more loving place, and I think we are confused between erotic love, eros, agape, unconditional love. I think our sexuality is a very different thing from our love, and that human beings we are complex, and that you know, there's a song that said there's not enough love to go around. It's an old song from the 60s, and I would say it's a kind of sad world in a way, where we really do need to make more loving contact with each other in all kinds of ways. And you know, we are a society fixated with sexuality, and it can be very cruel, and that when the love really and the respect and the consideration is missing, people live very isolated existences.
What has fame taught you?
I think that fame for fame's sake is a very toxic thing, very dangerous thing. And people in this society have this idea that they want to be famous, and they don't know what for. And they pursue celebrity for itself. And I would say that without something to offer, whether it be as that you're an actor, you have a craft, you have something to offer people, if you're a writer, a painter, a musician, when it's just about you and your life, it's a little bit cannibalistic. The industry of celebrity is quite a savage one, And when you fall foul of it, and your privacy is so brutally invaded, that even that, you know, you might be having difficulties in your life, as we all do, and that there is no boundary, and all the images of you, your dogs, your children, the inside of your house, they're all splattered across every front page. I think that's a very unhealthy place to be, and I think it's sad that people court it so sort of vociferously, you know.
Sing, my sister, sing.
Well, fame obviously also serves as a useful platform, and you've been very involved with various charities, notably HIV/AIDS. Do you ever feel frustrated that you're not making as big a difference as you would like?
I had to think about this very carefully, because I understand that there are so many problems in the world, infinitely, and there always will be. That will never change, no. Although things do change within that constraint. And if you make this decision to get involved, don't think that there's just an end result and that's what you're aiming for. No. It's the day-to-day commitment. It's the small steps that really count, in my opinion. So, you know, you can feel sometimes kind of overwhelmed by the issue, particularly HIV. It's a really complex issue. And until there's a cure for AIDS, there is no cure. And people are dealing with the symptoms, or they're trying to educate people about prevention. And that is really essential. So, I know that, having said that, that incredible things do happen, and that incredible things can happen, and if you leave the subject, if you leave it alone, that nothing does. So it's part of my decision was to just get on board and just to focus on that and just do that in my own way, and that's what the Sing campaign does.
In your 50s, how do you feel about where you are in life right now? Are you happy? Are you content?
Of course, now I'm in that middle age place, age-wise, and youth is no longer really something that I'm a part of anymore. And that started happening for me when I was about 40, to be honest with you, and I had my kids, and my focus went elsewhere. And I think I've changed so much through having children inside myself. There's been a kind of evolution and a maturity. And that has informed the Sing campaign a lot, because it's, you know, my focus is really on women, and women have children. And I am a woman and I have children. And I understand what it is for a woman to want to protect their children and give them the best they can. And so I identify with that. And I think as a human being now, I'm just in a very different place. I can let go of some of the things that were maybe I was focused on when I was younger, and I'm focused on different things.
So there must be a feeling of freedom that goes with that.
I'm finding it more and more as I evolve. I'm finding that there is a sense of liberation, yes. And a certain kind of autonomy, and there's a responsibility with that, but I really enjoy it. I like to be taking decisions, and I like to be thinking ahead of the game, and I like the freedom of creativity that I've been given.
You are shining light.